Welcome to Klebstack and another video in my continuing series on focus for stable diffusion. This video is basically a continuation of my last video on phase swap and tips for consistent characters. If you have not watched that, I do recommend watching it first. Don't forget, I do have many other videos on focus from install to poses and much more. So one of the ideas that I had talked about when getting a consistent character was the idea of having it create a grid of four different angles, things like that, of the same person, because when it does that in one generation, you're going to get that same person from those different angles. But one of the problems was getting the actual angles that I wanted. I could never get that, not consistently. So based upon some comments and some ideas that I had was looking at already as well, I thought, well, why not get some sort of reference chart to guide those angles that I wanted? And I did look online and there is some stuff out there, but I decided, why not just create my own? So what I decided to do was, as you can see here, I changed this over to just a line art setting. And I do a 10 by 10, 10 by 10, 24. You could do this on speed, I probably should have. But what this is doing is just go ahead and generating a human head facing left or right. Once you get the angles that you want, then you can go ahead and connect all those together. So once I had those generated and I went in, and I'll just go ahead and stop this now. So once I went ahead and had those generators, I went ahead and put them together and created this rough draft that I'll use to create my final one. Now you could do more angles, but when you start doing more angles, even when you upscale, when you start doing face swap, if the quality, the resolution isn't high enough, you may not get as good results. So you don't want to try to do too many different ones. So I've gone ahead and created this one. Now in here, what I would do at this point is once I've gotten those different angles, I've attached them, put them all into one reference sheet I want to use. Click off input image, go into my image prompt, make sure you have the advanced box checked at the bottom. I'm going to bring in that rough one I created, switch it over to Pyrocani. I'll leave those just as they are. That's perfectly fine for my purposes here. I'm going to go ahead and create another one. And this will just create a new chart. So it's going to use this one down here to create just a little bit better one that they're all more consistent. I don't think it probably really wouldn't make much of a difference. That's just how I was doing it. So at this point, let's say we have the chart that we want, which that would be perfectly fine for our purposes. At that point, I can go ahead and I'll cancel this one out down here. I'm also going to uncheck. I'll change that over to speed or quality now. And then I'm going to uncheck line art. I'll set these back to where I had them for what I was doing. Okay, so now I have my reference chart finished, and I can use that to create the different angles for that consistent character. So then I can go ahead, come up with whatever I want to describe the person. I'm telling you, I want a grid of four images. Now it's going to use this down here as a reference. So even though I could get that grid without using that, I wouldn't, as my other video showed, you couldn't get consistently different set angles that you wanted. So this way we're guiding it. Now I'm going to go ahead here and generate a character to use for the face swap. I've got everything all set. I got this on Pyrocani. So let's go ahead and generate that. Yeah, I'm going to go ahead and stop it there because I actually got good enough results for what I'm going to show. So that gives you an idea of how you can get those different angles. Now, if we had set the stop at a lower angle, these faces, she would have turned more towards the camera. So that's why you want to play around with that until you get the results that you're looking for. But that'll give you a pretty good idea of how to get those consistency for the different angles. And obviously, which angle you use is up to you. You probably only need one profile, left or right, and then a couple different ones, and then you can work from there. So now we have our character that we're going to use, but we want to get the quality higher at this point. So I'm going to go ahead and go into the upscale and variation. I'm going to drop this down in here. Now, the key to remember is when we go into the upscale here, if we do the 1.5 or the 2x, that is going to change it slightly. It'll vary it subtly. So if you have very exactly the face that you're looking for, or if you use something else as a guide, the face swap to get to this or something like that, and you don't want to change that, you might want to just do the standard 2x, the fast 2x, I mean, because that just does a standard upscale. I'm going to go ahead and do the upscale 2x on this. Okay, since my system doesn't like to upscale and record, I'm going to actually use the images I created earlier when I was testing this out. And so what I ended up with was this image here, which was fully generated and upscaled. Now, at that point, I split that into four different images. I just opened it in Paint, cropped each section off, and saved them all as separate images. So now I have four different images that I can use when I want to. Yes, more pictures are useful, and for one reason alone, is I find a lot of objects, if you have a hat in the picture and you only use one picture with that hat, that's gonna always have a hat, pretty much. But if you have multiple pictures and only one has the hat, then it's less likely gonna influence those resulting images. And partially that depends on the weight and everything else. So at this point, we have our four images that we have. I'm gonna put all these on face swap for now, but I'm gonna actually demonstrate that there's benefits to more than one and just having one. It all depends on what you're shooting for. Basically, if you're shooting for exactly the angle that you have, like the straight at the camera, I'd probably just use the one here and I'd get rid of these other ones because I have no reason to have these other images because they're gonna actually potentially negatively, you know, influence it. So, and lowering of the weight on them isn't gonna help either because that what that does pretty much is it influences it not only by just not using those as much, but also you'll find you'll get less of a resemblance. I've found at least it seems that way. If I go ahead and I'm just gonna say, let's see, a beautiful woman with red hair, silver blue eyes. Well, let's do long hair. Okay, so now we'll go ahead and I'm gonna generate. We have this set for all these are set on face swap. And we'll go ahead and just for general, well, I'll go ahead and generate it on quality. Now, the one thing I do find when we have the multiple angles in here, I get more variety when I don't do anything else, when I just put in having coffee. If I remove that and only just have one of these in there, it'll use that. So if I were to just have the straight on one, almost all of them will come out with the straight on look. If I use one of these other angles, that'll impact it as well. So that's one thing that I found that you really, it helps you shape the generation. So you can use the between the prompt. I'll show you for example here. We're gonna get rid of these two. So I'm going to do the same thing, but I'm going to say side shot. And the thing I've left is down here on the profile view more. It's not exactly a profile, but it's much closer. And I got to crank up that weight. I should have done that before, but we're going to do it quite a bit there. Now I'm going to go ahead and generate again on this. And we're going to actually use the same seeds for these and we'll generate. So now we have our shots that are more in tune with that profile, semi-profile shot. I don't know what you want to call that. But if we have more of a profile shot, I didn't actually have one on one of those. Yeah, so that's when you can use your other slots to bring in. And well, it doesn't want to do it. Okay, there we go. And we use Pyrocani. So now we have our face and we have our pose that we're looking for, and we're gonna go ahead and generate. Okay, so you get the idea. Now we have the pose, we can utilize that. The problem is a lot of times you're gonna have to work on the eyes. A lot of these things also you can adjust the weight. So I'm not gonna go through that and keep generating, but a lot of times increasing or decreasing, keep playing around with it. So if we want to have less of an influence, you know, we could lower this down a little bit, but you're going to lose some of that similarity potentially. So as for impainting and face swap, that's I find to get mixed results. There's a lot of factors that come into play, the face, what you have. I find when you're generating it works pretty well, very, very well. I actually find I can get very good results. But when you start doing the impainting, it's not always the greatest. I'm not a big fan of, well, let's start with this. I'll just demonstrate a couple of things. Now, there's a couple of different ways that you can do this. And really, a lot of times, one comes out better than the other. So I've experimented and usually try both to start with, and then whichever one looks better, I work from there. We're gonna use this image. We're gonna use this one, this face, as the face swap for this. I will paint over the area. Now, remember, it's gonna have to blend things in, so you wanna be careful in how you do this. Sometimes you wanna be a little more accurate when it comes to skin shade, because sometimes it will get lines. And then under the advanced, you're gonna have to go into the developer debug mode. And in here, you wanna check off mixing image prompt and impaint. So you wanna have that checked. Now, depending on what you're doing, the method that you do, you would also need to keep in mind this is what it's normally like. When you do the impainting, there's a refiner switch. And what happens is, if you just do regular impainting, like that's set right now without changing anything, the last like approximately 30%, it's gonna change the image, the face so much that it probably isn't gonna look like the same. Sometimes it does and it tricked me before, but so what I find is you have to go into the developer debug mode and also change the force overwrite refiner switch step. And if you set that up in about 48, you can go ahead and generate and get some images. The problem is you're not gonna get some of the great ones. You'll get, it works, but that's one method of doing it. So you can do it that way. And then the other way is to improve detail. And then we can go in here, detail girl's face. Now, when you do it this way with the improved detail, you don't need to change the refiner switch. But you do need to have still the mixing image prompt and the impaint set. So we'll go ahead at this point. We have these set to a high weight. I have the impaint or outpaint, and we have that set to the detailed face. And we're gonna go ahead and generate, well, I'm just gonna generate one on that for now, just to show how it works. Okay, so now we have our final product there. It seemed to have done a better job than the other one. Now, the other thing you can do at this point, if we want to, and I'm going to show you a different method. Now, this can be done with or without the impainting. I actually use it. Sometimes I'll do the impainting first like this. And then I'll go into the upscale and variation. Now, in here, we have to change this from the impainting. We don't have to change it. I think you can leave them both on. I don't know. But mixing image prompt and vary upscale now. And so in here, I'm gonna put it on just vary. I'm gonna drag this down here. So that's the one we just did with the impaint. We could have done it with the original as well. It's hit or miss on which one. You can experiment with all these different methods. This is the face we're gonna be using for the face swap, but now it's gonna be under the vary upscale. I'm gonna get rid of this one in the impaint so there's no confusion. And so at this point, we can also try to get a different expression. As somebody had commented, you can use the variation to try to get one. So I'm gonna go ahead and use a big smile, and I'm gonna actually just increase some weight because I do know one thing. Usually you need to increase that weight. I'm gonna lower the stop add on this to make it a little bit easier, hopefully, to do that. Okay, so we now have our variation on that other one, and we can pull that up. Now, I'm not a huge fan. I still think it's not great. I would go in with photo editing app and adjust the colors slightly. But it, did a pretty good job with the face swap. To get that smile, you do need to reduce the weight a little bit, so you're gonna lose a little bit of the similarities. But everybody's faces is different when they're smiling, angry, different expressions. So, that's how the impainting works. like I said, that's hit or miss. I've gotten some really good results out of this, and then I've got some mediocre results out of this, and not so great results out of it. But one of the biggest things you want to remember is if you're using this, the straight on face in the face swap, and you're generating with that, the face is going to always want to be pulling and looking at the camera when you go to generate anything, no matter what you try to generate. It's going to always be trying to do that. Just keep experimenting, but those are a lot of the tools that you have at your disposal. The upscale and variation one, I didn't mention in my last video because I didn't even think about that, but that works. That actually works pretty well. Sometimes if there's only one person in there, I will just boom, I'll use that. I won't bother with the in painting at all. I'll just skip the in painting and go right to the upscale and variation. If you found this video helpful, please do consider the like button because it does help. Don't forget to check out my other videos on focus. And any questions or even more tips on getting better results, definitely leave them in the comments. And have a great day.